It is 2019, and this is our first investigation of the year. With David still on the sidelines, the team returned to a place which played a major role in myself returning to the paranormal field. In 2018, I ended up spending over a month in hospital. After a week and a half in a coma, I had risen from this deep sleep, and I had woke up to a fractured skull, a bleed on the brain, I couldn't walk, and I was unable to speak. But during this time, I made contact with the spiritual world, and I was being watched over by a male and female spirit in my own hospital room. Although I could never see their faces, I could see their clothes, their shoes, and even their hairstyles. These spirits were from an older generation, and I know that they were there. I had a strong spiritual feeling that they were former family members who had come and encouraged me to pull through. As the hospital staff discovered about my role in the paranormal field due to my mother from Dark Dreams Paranormal letting them know, they would come forward enough to speak to me in regards to hauntings that appear on the very floor in which I was staying. One thing included the shower coming on at random times at night in the room directly across from mine. In the time that I was there, I heard this happen not once, but twice. Footsteps could often be heard walking down the corridors, and a woman had even taken her own life on the same floor after a failed suicide attempt. In the days I was observed by these friendly spirits, something strange happened on the fourth night. My get well cards were placed where the male spirit who I believed to be my great grandfather sat, when suddenly these cards were thrown across the room. I took this as a message that I would be okay, and this was his way of saying goodbye. The place we visit tonight is a former anti-aircraft site, which during my leave from the hospital, this was the first place I came with the crew in order to get myself back out there. We have no history of anyone actually dying in this location, but we do know that during this time the place was set up, not a single shot was fired at the German Air Force during the Blitz of World War II.
Various rooms existed. We know that men and women would have worked here. What is this room over here? Could you possibly show yourself? Could you maybe walk past the bars on the inside of the building? Hi guys, and welcome to Soul Reaper Paranormal. It's 2019 and we know that ghosts exist. We've seen them. Now, early on in 2018, I actually was attacked in town and actually nearly died of a brain injury. I had a bleed on the brain, a fractured skull, and you guys have all seen me, and I'm a bit of a mess, wasn't I?
Definitely.
Once I got out of hospital, this was one of the first places we actually come. Kind of a warm-up, trying to get back into it, trying to make myself walk, and trying to make myself move around. And we did actually conduct a live investigation. Can you tell people what actually happened during that live stream?
Yeah, like Kyle says, it was kind of like a little warm-up. Just a new location to try out. On the live, we heard 100%, and also most people watching the live heard coughing, and it weren't us. There were three of us here, it was none of us.
100% bought us, and people, like you just said, that were watching the live stream at the time actually reported the same thing. We don't know what we're going to catch here tonight. You guys have voted me for a lone vigil tonight. I've not done it for a while since the farmhouse when this voice were captured.
Whoa!
It's a shame you didn't get it.
Yeah,
you
know, vote me next time.
Vote this guy next time. James won't do it. But we're here, we're going to get started and we're going to see what happens. So, we're about to conduct our investigation. As you can see, Matt's got a REM pod. I've got the K2, which is already turned on. If you want to set that up, mate, we'll begin to call out and we'll see what happens.
Yeah, stop running that door.
Yeah, it would have been an active place, you know.
Yeah.
At the time that this existed, soldiers would have been known for actually going there and walking in and out of that building. Mike set up the REM pod. Basically what this device does is creates its own magnetic bubble. Basically we believe that spirits can, you know, manipulate magnetic energy, and that's what we're looking for, that to go off usually on command. So I think it's about time we started. If there is anyone here that can hear my voice at this moment in time, we've been here before. If you are here right now, is it possible for you to give us a sign, to show yourself as a ball of light, to make a noise, to show us that you are around? We know that the dead exist. We've communicated with you guys before, and that's why we're here tonight, to show that you are still around and that you're intelligent.
Is the person that we heard last time coughing still here? If you are, could you let us know by setting off this device? Let's go close to it and try and touch it. Do we hear a noise?
I heard parts of it. We know that this place was once active. We know that your job was to shoot down German aircraft during the Blitz. We are aware that not a shot was fired from this area. But we do know that people worked here. I think it was up to 250 people that were stationed here. Yeah. And we know eventually you moved to the coast. Can you please try and do something right now? This device I've got in my hand has one green light on it. If you can manipulate this, show us that you are here, could you do that right now? Just do it once for the camera, for the people that are watching. Try and show them that you are here. We've done this a while, we know how you guys work. We know that you give us signs, we know that you manipulate your environment. We know that you affect people by flying into them as balls of light. This happens to you quite a bit.
A lot,
from all videos I've watched, you are usually one that gets attacked by these balls of light.
I generally react as well, don't I?
You always see them, but you don't see them, you know?
I believe this place was formerly known as H17. Any former workers of H17 that's come back to check on the place, can you let us know that you are here by showing yourself as a ball of light and directing yourself at me?
This little device here, basically what it does is it lights up and illuminates. Basically, I want you to do that to show us that you're here. If you've heard my voice right now and you've just seen what I've done, is it possible for you to do that for me right now? Come on. We're very respectful to you guys, and we want respect in the same way that we're giving to you. We mean you no disrespect whatsoever. We're not mocking you in any way. We're just looking for proof that you are around us tonight. We've learnt a lot in the last 2 years that we've done this. And we are forever trying to enhance the way that we work.
And you guys are constantly teaching us. Without you, there's nobody to learn from. So we do really appreciate that. We are honoured. We'd just like you to continue to do the same. Just by letting us know. Just let us know that you're here. That's all we're asking for now.
That's all we want, guys. We know that a command base was here. We know that various rooms existed. We know that men and women would have worked here. What is this room over here? Could you possibly show yourself? Could you maybe walk past the bars on the inside of the building?
You feel like a tapping,
man. Yeah, it's somewhere.
Three taps.
Oh, is that your feet, James, made that noise? Ah, yeah, that's it.
In a moment, we're going to go in a room and we're going to turn on a device that will give you a voice. I think what we'll do at this stage is find a building that we're happy with, we'll set up a quality spot, we'll fire that off for 10 minutes, we'll see what we get, and then we'll move further afield and actually enter another part of this
location.
There is
quite a few little buildings here, isn't there?
I mean, last time we come here, we're actually pretty much chock-a-block, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And as you can see from this video, guys, you'll get an idea of how busy this place was with nature. You know, it took over all the buildings. James has come down, cleared a bit of the area, and we can walk straight in.
Right then, so we've moved into ammunition storage room, I believe. We're going to try a Coltus box, obviously from a sponsor, Mark Coltus. Go and check them out, guys. Probably the best bit of kit we've got, in my opinion, anyway.
These, you know, these guys, you can purchase one of these for about 150... Now you can purchase one of these for around £150. My mother's just bought one, you know, Diabetes Paranormal. You can get them in various different colours. Really, really good at what they do. They've done the job perfectly. Some of the things we've captured on them has been absolutely amazing. I think you should turn that on, try and make some contact, and we'll see if we can communicate with anyone. Is there anyone here with us tonight? We've come in search of the afterlife, of the paranormal. Do you know who we are and why we're here tonight? We're here to document that you exist once you leave this world. Could you give us a sign? Could you maybe speak to us? And possibly say that you're a ghost or a spirit?
It sounded like the three or we. There was somewhere last year where we kept the end friends with monsters. Haven't you?
This is. Could you say who you are? We think we've just heard a noise right now, and it sounded like a bit of tapping, didn't it? A bit like this. If that was you, could you do that again right now? I very thought then, at that exact minute, that I heard a voice then. You might not have heard it, but I could hear someone talking. I hope that that's on an EVP then, I swear to God, I'm sure I heard it.
You can't walk on top of this, can you?
Maybe with that plane.
No, it would have definitely.
I did hear it. What's up? Why do you keep looking over there?
I don't know.
Should we go over there?
I think so, I just think.
Let's try over there. Right, so we've basically moved room now. It looks like the same sort of thing. Another room that's possibly a storage bunker or something like that. We're going to turn cultist box on again, try again, see if we can get anything. We know that this place was used during the war. If you were based here, could you say what your job was?
When you were talking, it said not me. But please try really hard. We know you don't like this device. Could you maybe just say H17? This place is just referring to us.
That's what you're before, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Why do you remain here? What is your role? Are you here to protect? Are you here in a different dimension? Are you doing the job that you once did? Right, so what was your job? What did you shoot down from the air, or try to shoot down?
What was it?
What a plane.
If you didn't just say a plane, could you try really hard to say it again?
We know that you often get called a spirit or a ghost, that would mean.
Normal.
If you are a spirit or a ghost, which do you prefer? Do you like to be called a spirit, a ghost, or just a normal person? Please try and say what it is that you prefer.
Ben.
Ben?
Do you prefer to be called by your first name? If that's correct, can you say your name again?
What about this device? Can you see it right here with the little green light? If you can see that light, could you say green? Green.
It's all right, isn't it?
If you just said green, could you say it again? We're looking for validation. Green. Come in here. This device
is... Of course, brother.
I used to be in the military. I used to be in the army. If you've heard what I've just said, could you say that word army?
Farmers.
We've had strange things happen to us during investigations. We've seen shadows with the naked eye. We've been touched. And we've even caught spirits on camera. Could you do something right now? Could you maybe set off this device? Is there a way you could do that? Please try and do that for me now then, guys. Like I said, we come here with no disrespect. We just have to prove that you're here.
I didn't feel a touch on that though, when you said keep a smile.
Yeah.
I'm unsure whether it was just like a spider or something like that kind of thing.
This device is called a REM pod.
Wait.
Can you set that off?
It's something or I'm leaving.
And this is called a K2.
What do we need to do to make you not leave just yet and have to communicate with us?
That's a REM pod. Did you hear that then?
It's hard to work it then, yeah.
This is called a cultist box. Do you know the name of the guy that invented this? Like talking, like a conversation, yeah. Did you hear that?
Fucking busy place, isn't it?
Did anyone die here? In this area? That was my mother. Read this to me, and we know you're here. This is the first word. This is what we're looking for. Can't.
Shit.
Shit.
Yeah, shit or shit.
Let's keep trying to get validation. How many fingers am I holding in the air right now? If you're wrong. Birds. Do you hear the birds then? We've had this numerous times. Yeah. Birds tweeting like a different dimension.
We had that in my environment.
How many fingers, guys? Come on. What were that? Come on. Direct answer right now, guys. That was me. Direct answer right now, guys.
Wake up.
Wake up. Wake up. Yeah. Dead.
Travel
back. Why, who's here? Who's here with us right now? Bit of magic. For the last 4 days, I've seen the number 333 numerous times. Can you explain to me why that is? Whose card's that? What does it mean?
About
4 days in a row, twice a day.
Right.
What is 333? Who's done that? What does it mean to us? Because I'm guessing you've had something happen with that as well.
It's not me, somebody messaged me on Facebook about it.
This one speaker, 14-year-old boy, from the forest reports a rape.
14-year-old boy reports of a forest and rape. Do you know what had happened to me before I come to this place where I was?
Might just recreate
what?
I don't know on about you actually.
That just said Fort Paul. Did you hear that?
I did.
Fort Paul.
I didn't until you said it. That's definitely what it was.
Yeah, yeah.
Huh?
No, yeah, yeah.
We have just got camera, we have actually just read about Fort Paul. Mental.
Up.
Where?
Oh.
Full front bomb at screen towards the other head.
Again. Are you around me right now?
Like flew into your face.
Spirits. Thank you. How many of you guys are here right now?
Share.
Can you give us a name? One of our names?
My left hand's going really cold.
Is it?
Your left hand.
I'm going to take a photo.
Hey, did you see my name as well, guys? Follow that.
Can you tell me how many spirits are present? Have you just touched James's hand?
If you have touched...
Men's are red hot.
Hello? It's weird that it is really cold in here. See, I just felt a bit of a tickle down my hand. It was a bit strong.
Should we take some photos of y'all? Should we call it out, man?
Yeah.
Right, guys, so we're going to try something different. This is a box from Nigel Mortimer. It's called an FCD04. He no longer actually makes these boxes. What's up?
I just felt like a push on my bag.
Did you see how I fell over, though? Like, I lost my balance.
It was if somebody's just gone like that on my back. You see, I'm trying to fucking fasten this up.
Now, literally, we just turned this on for a moment and we heard something straight away, didn't we?
Yeah, yeah.
And basically, this box is developed by Nigel Mortimer. He no longer actually makes these boxes. My mother purchases for me for Christmas. It's the first time we've used it on an investigation. James has tested this at home. You had some pretty good stuff come through and you turned it off straight away, didn't you? As you can see, guys, it's got a reverb mechanism on it, so we can play with that, kind of see what we can get. But I'll just turn it on, we'll rock and roll, and we'll see what happens.
Yep.
Reconciliation.
Reconciliation. Good evening, spirits. My name is Kyle.
And I'm Mark.
And that's James. Can you see us right now?
You find this device is easy to use as a cultist box? If you do, just say yes.
Is there anyone with us right now? That's like all warm music. Want it?
Yeah.
Wow. Thank you. Is that what you listened to at the time?
The reply there. It sounded like yes.
Could you maybe say how many of us that are alive you can see? CD box, you've got to keep this and sweep when it stops.
Right.
Who's the girl? What's your name, dear?
It's Ashley.
Ash.
It's Ash. Ashley? Were you born in this area?
Just looking behind that way, mate, because there's something.
Again, a force.
That was very clear. That looked like an instant reply.
It was really,
it's Ash.
Really good.
What about his name? It's Mark. Could you say that?
Is that your James? I can't know it.
His name is Mark. Could you say that for us?
Thank you.
with something.
It's his first building, so it's really more comfortable in.
We're hearing stuff going off outside.
Should we take it outside?
Let's take it outside. We're here to document your existence. Did anyone die that worked here?
We're asking these questions for us, so you do already know that you exist.
The word you say.
It's literally for other people around the world. We believe that you deserve some credit.
We want to remember you just like everyone else.
The campus boy.
Can you see that K2 keeps going on?
Does it?
And we stand behind it.
Yeah.
If you're affecting that device, could you do it right now for me? Give us an extra light. Show us that you're here.
Start talking if I'm giving.
And as each year.
Yeah, so we've just debunked, guys. K2 going off is actually set off and it's too close to that spirit box.
And just to further debunk that, we'll just put it back here to prove that.
You know, we're all about debunking stuff.
Watch this.
There you go. So there's a big burst.
Every time there's that static burst.
And I have to get dead.
Yeah, so we know that will do, too, and we've done that.
That's a good spotting, guys.
Yeah, well done, James.
Yeah.
Did you enjoy working during the war?
Give enough.
What were we that?
What country were we at war against? What country? Or even better, who was in charge of that country? Who ran it? Right, guys, so I'm about to do my lone vigil. Thanks for voting me once again. Not happy at all, but it is what it is. As you guys know, the last time I actually did one was in the house on Haunted Hill, and we actually captured this voice.
Whoa!
A voice which literally scared the crap out of me. Now, we've come to an old artillery site that was used during the Blitz, and we've had a real quiet night. However, I am actually here now, and I'm going to conduct this investigation by myself in this room. The guys have moved off, they've left me alone. So I think I'm just going to start by calling out. We'll have a couple of minutes doing that, and then if that fails, I'll turn on the cultist box. We'll have a few moments doing that. So thank you for watching this video, and thanks for my cultist who provided us with this magnificent box. If there's any spirits here with me right now, I've come here in 2018 after I've left hospital. If you were here and you were the person that actually coughed on a live stream to our fans, which was heard by numerous people, could you maybe do that for me right now? Could you possibly show yourself as a ball of light? Could you maybe fly towards my hand? What I've got here, guys, is a device called a K2. If you are here right now, could you maybe set off this device? Give me an extra light. Make your presence known. Myself and Mark feel like we've been moved tonight. We feel like something's pushed us over, maybe bumped into us. We've got a girl come through by the name of Ash through the FCD-04 box, which was created by Nigel Mortimer. When I do turn on this cultist box, Spades, Ash, if you are here, we want you to come through and speak in this device so we've got double validation that that was you and you are a spirit that's present. We don't know what's happened to you and we are truly sorry for that. If you actually died in this area, or if you are a spirit that's followed us, or someone that was local to this area, then obviously we do want to communicate with you. We need to know who you are and what it is that you want, why you're here, why you remain. No disrespect whatsoever to any spirits that are present, to any dimensional beings, to any nature spirits, any elementals, anything, whatever you are, we mean you no disrespect whatsoever. But I think at this stage, guys, I need you to try and make a noise, try and show yourself, try and give me a sign that you are present. We're looking for balls of light. We're looking for you to do something right now. I'm going to turn yourself away from the camera. So if you can try and affect that device right now in my hand, that'll be magnificent. We're just here to try and document proof that you exist. That's all we want. We're here to show people around the world that you are real. We know that you're real because we've seen you numerous times. Mark has seen spirits with the naked eye. I've seen spirits with the naked eye. James has seen things. Dave has seen things. We know that you're real. We just want to document that. So what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to turn on the cultist box. I'm going to put this device over here a moment while I set this up, and then I'll pick it back up. Now, once again, thanks to Mark Cultist for creating this device. It's really, really good box, guys, and numerous people have these now. So I'm going to turn this on, and we're just going to see what happens. Good evening, spirits. Can anyone hear my voice?
You're willing to show up.
You're willing to show off? Well, please do that right now. I know that most spirits are really, really good. And they're really communicative. You are brilliant. Yes, that's correct. We know that you used to try to shoot planes down in this area. Did you hear that? If you are a spirit that's just lapsed from this device, whoa! I used to be a soldier myself. Do we have anything in common? If you were a soldier, did you say that? Ashley, if you were there, could you say Ash again? Come on. I heard you say some of the title then. You did, yes, you did. Well done. Come on. Come on, say something really good for me. Oh, I'm hearing noises in here. You're small? You're very small?
It's funny, man.
Why are you so small? Stop screaming. I'm not screaming. I'm just speaking to you. I don't know how clear you can hear my voice. I do apologise. Could you maybe just say what the name of my team is on this top? Come on. Give me something. We're here to try and document you. The device that I'm pointing at right now is called a camera.
It's...
That's it, in the woods. We heard earlier that someone was raped in the woods, I believe. Is that you? It was.
The conversation.
I've got a feeling that you're a boy, a young boy. Well, I want to thank you for taking the time to speak to me tonight and the rest of the team. Could you maybe say goodbye? Whoa! Fucking hell, all that. We're definitely a noise in this room, man. Soul Reapers, yes, we are. Thank you. Goodbye, guys. Thank you for taking the time to speak to me right now. Right, guys, so it does appear that we're having a quiet investigation, but as you guys know, obviously once I've edited this video and I've seen things that we've missed, we do usually get quite interested and we see a lot of things happening that we've missed out on. I do think I've heard some real intelligent responses tonight, and I'm pretty certain that I've heard mine and Mark's name throughout the night. What? Heard some real interesting stuff. That voice,
that laugh, what is that?
Over multiple sweeps, that it won't just from one radio station, that went on for a few.
Yeah.
I seen like a ball of light in this corner, and I jumped up. I heard something walk on the floor on these bottles, and I was stood right over here, which is pretty solid concrete. What's up?
Just keep it in full steps.
It's weird, there's all in here. Yeah, good thing you've got all to add about what you felt tonight.
This particular bit of, the building just across from us that we were in not long ago is the only building tonight when I felt uncomfortable.